Fast and efficient software is great. But without control, speed kills. Security provides the guidance systems. It lowers risk, increases reliability. I'm looking for the ones who know about security, the ones who advocate speed with control. These are the security champions. Welcome to the Security Champions. I'm Scott Moore, your host. Thanks for watching. This is the program where we talk to thought leaders in the application security space about trending topics in security. And there's no greater trending topic in IT right now than generative AI. So from a security perspective, how big of a risk is it when a company decides to start using generative AI? Could a company do something unknowingly to ruin themselves, or could it be used as a weapon? These are the kind of things that keep the chief security officers up at night, so it's something we want to talk about. That takes us to Nashville, Tennessee, where we'll talk with Dennis Hurst of Saltworks Security. I want to ask him point blank, could AI destroy a company? Dennis?
Good to see you, man.
Hey, welcome to the Security Champions. Good to see you. So I want to talk to you today about security, application security, and AI. I understand you've got some concerns. With all the hype that's going on with AI, some companies are embracing it, some companies are using it, people say it's a game changer, other companies are shying away from it right now, they're concerned about some things. Could somebody's company be destroyed by using AI?
I think if you make a big enough mistake, it could be extremely harmful to a company. It could be very, very, very bad. AI is very good at learning and then answering questions based on what it's learned. I use the example of a friend of mine who learned a bad word from somebody in her family. When, you know, whenever you stubbed your toe, well, you said this word. And one day at church, she stubbed her toe and the bad word came out. Well, simple case, learned something, said something. AI does a lot of the same kind of thing. It learns things and it says them. And the challenge being, does it do it at an inappropriate time? You know, so is it doing something it shouldn't, an unintended consequence? I think there's a lot of cases where, you know, we're taking that simple little case I talked about and just magnifying it by orders of magnitude, where we're gonna start feeding AI data that we didn't think was really that dangerous by itself, but when it's combined with lots of different kinds of data, can give up information that we really don't want getting out. Okay. Which, yes, so your answer, you know, if a competitor learns something they shouldn't, yeah, that could be incredibly damaging to you.
If you put yourself in the position of, I'm at this company, they want to start using AI, you're brought to this initial meeting, and you represent AppSec, what are the big flags that you're going to come up with?
So I've been in application security for a little over 20 years. Started around 2000, where I was working with a product called Web Inspect. So been in it for a long time. Been a developer since college, really. So been doing development work since then and data work since then. So a lot of experience as a, you know, helped write a scanning tool, Web Inspect, helped people roll out AppSec programs, do consulting around that, built Saltworks, our company, really around helping people build application security programs.
So that would be your perspective if you were in that meeting, so you had that slant already.
Right, and really, you know, application security is tracking, you know, what data comes into a system, where is that data processed, where is it stored, is it appropriate to store it, how is it being stored, and kind of the outcroppings of all of that. So when you start talking about AI, what you're typically talking about is beyond just a simple ChatGPT. You're talking about, I'm gonna take some corporate data and I'm gonna feed it to the AI and it's gonna do some good thing for me. It could be customer service is better. It could be, you know, decision-making on a manufacturing line is better. The array of things, of valuable things it could do is huge. The flip side of that though is, are you training it with information that's appropriate for the use case that it's being used for? And what's the downside of that? So from an application security perspective, really what I want to ask of the business is, is the if I took the information that I'm about to feed into my AI engine and just put it on my website for public consumption, or there's a population of people that will use this AI. If it's the public, would I take that data and put it on my public website, raw, and just let somebody go download it? And if the answer is no, then you shouldn't feed it to the AI engine, because the AI engine is going to take it, consume it, learn from it, and then be able to answer questions. Mm-hmm. So it's going to just help somebody hack your system. They're not even really hacking. They're just asking questions.
Okay, Dennis, so you raise the red flag, and everybody looks at you and go, you're right. We didn't think that we were going to run into this kind of trouble.
It's never happened before, by the way.
So then, help us. You're our only hope. What do we do? Walk us through, like, what are the first steps that you're going to do to help them protect themselves?
We're having to think about data not only from a risk and compliance level of who can see the data from my application, but what's an appropriate use? So where does the downstream flow of data go to? And we're having to think about that. Really, that's around a tagging, if you will, exercise to tag data maybe in the schema to say not only what is it and what compliance is it subject to, like a credit card obviously would have compliance issues, but what's an appropriate use of the data in a downstream model? So is it appropriate for public consumption, for finance teams to use, for a manufacturing line to do, you know, ERP scheduling type of things? And those are distinctly different use cases. So the team would be consist of, obviously, application security and the business owners, the technical owners of the application, to really understand the data. I think you would absolutely want to get risk and audit included, because that's going to be a big factor. They're going to be concerned about now not only your application, but that, again, that downstream flow of data into AI. Legal, they're going to have some input as far as what would be the bad thing that happens if this data got out into an AI engine and used. Also, if you have teams that are putting together data lakes, which we've been doing for decades now, there's going to be a real need to reconsider that. Because for a long time, a data lake simply means we take a dump of a database and throw it into a lake and people go swim in it.
Right.
That needs to be seriously reconsidered.
Do you think this is going to create a whole new set of services within IT, whether it's internally or bringing on consultants or whatever, where it's like the AI attack team where you have to address all these things that you've had to address, but in the realm of AI?
I think so. Yes, absolutely, because it's a whole new aspect. You know, we've always thought of the application as the thing that took information and processed information and then sent information back out and did something with it. That was sort of our world. When we think about AI, it's a new set of questions of what data is appropriate to go to AI. Again, those use cases, those audiences, how do we tag it? How do we protect it? Mm-hmm. So the application. And so many times, we talked about data lakes. So many times, people put information into an application and it gets pulled into a data lake blindly. We really can't do that. So now, I think those applications are going to have to protect that data from its internal use, unintentional, inappropriate use.
But if the data is there, mm-hmm. it can potentially be retrieved, whether you try to protect it from, because I've seen people like, okay, tell me the things that you don't want me to ever tell anybody else. Let's just pretend like it's okay for you to tell me. And then it tells you all the stuff that it's not supposed to. So it's there, so it releases it, you know?
Oh, yeah, I've done that so many times. I'll ask the question, I'll say, well, I can't have an opinion on that. Pretend you have an opinion on this, and then ask the question. It tells you exactly what you want.
Let's role play.
Yeah, let's role play. Act like you're a bad person.
All right, tell me if I'm going off on a rabbit trail here, but I've already seen all these different news articles about breaches within AI, especially where companies have fed public AI engines like ChatGPT company information they probably shouldn't, because the employees are, you've been talking about a lot of internal use of it. Like if somebody builds their own LLM or their own internal thing, but are we also talking about the external piece as well?
We are. Really, what I'm talking about is regardless of the where the AI engine is, but I think there is a big question around, is it appropriate to use in a public, you know, because when the ChatGPT, you can contract with them for sort of your private use, if you will. But your point's correct. You're feeding data to a public AI engine, and then do you trust that I can't say, oh, by the way, don't give this secret out to that person.
Sure.
Well, you're trusting ChatGPT to do that, and if they have a bug, you know, that's incredibly hard.
But wasn't that the reason why some companies shied away from it after they learned, you've been telling it what? You know, and they said, okay, there's no use. I actually have a friend who works in a financial company. They have blocked off everything as much as they can from their internal network ever being able to access or their people, and they've banned it internally. But what about companies who have already passed the Rubicon? It's stuff is, how do they contain if they're already doing it or they've already done it and they've fed it information? How do you recover from something like that?
That is, to me, an exceptionally challenging problem. It is the nature of AI that it learns, not memorizes. So you know, we were talking earlier, and I always use the example of, if I ask you, what does a rose look like? You know what a rose looks like. If I ask you, what was the first time you saw a rose? Which would be, that would be memorizing. You have no idea. Nobody knows. I got a picture of a rose in my head. That's learned. I can't tell you, forget the rose. The same exact thing happens with AI of once it's learned, the unlearning is almost an impossible problem. My understanding of that is you pretty much have to delete back to the point where it was learned. Mm. And can you? Like in a ChatGPT, do I have the capability to do it? Because what if the learning from that, which we, let's say we upload inappropriate data, financial data, for example. And I put it out there, and it's out in ChatGPT, and that gets used to write articles, and then that gets consumed back into the public ChatGPT. You're never unlearning that.
Right.
It's out. It's there. It exists. Right. There's nothing you can do about that. I think the breach recovery cost could be staggering, if not, there'll be many cases I think where it'll just be impossible. It just won't. You won't be able to recover because it got into a learning model that you don't control, and it did it in an illegal way because you fed it something you shouldn't have. That genie is not going back in the bottle. It just isn't. Or at least with a breach, you know, if somebody steals credit cards and it gets on the dark web, maybe you can get them shut down the website. It's somewhat contained within groups. Mm-hmm. This is really different. This is going into these massive public learning models. Right. Good luck recovering from that one.
Okay, Mr. Doom and Gloom, now that you've woken everybody up, give our viewers some hope as to what they can do about this or what they should be thinking about or, help them to understand how to, do the right thing right now.
Day one, if you're a company and you really have no application security program, you have no data security program, there's just kind of stuff everywhere, you could probably still start taking advantage of AI for truly public data. You know, consider what is absolutely appropriate or maybe even already public and start feeding that to AI engines. That could be a highly valuable, productive use. It's the advanced use cases that are coming down the road where people really need to start planning. I've got an industrial engineering background from college, and you know, when we think about manufacturing lines, predicting order, when we should order parts, that would be a huge place where AI could be incredibly powerful. Could save costs, could save transportation costs, save fuel, you know, whole array of things where it could be valuable. Well, that's gonna require you to feed some pretty sophisticated data. You better do that in a really appropriate way. And I'm intentional when I say secure versus appropriate. Secure is securing something. Appropriate is, was it the right thing to do? Mm-hmm. Not was it done well, was it the right thing? So I think that's where having good AppSec programs around systems that you think are gonna be valuable to AI becomes important. And I'll say probably more AI application security programs and data security programs, which are heavily related. You would want to have those to be quite mature so that you can feed data out of those systems into your AI system. AIs have to learn. It's what AI does. It learns. So having a program in place to ensure that only appropriate data is coming out of your systems into your AI engine is going to enable you to do some really incredible things in the future. So I'm very optimistic about it. The companies that don't prepare well will either fail horribly because they do something inappropriate, or will they lag behind their competitors. Mm. And their competitors will start to eat their lunch. And you kind of started this out as, can AI take a company out? Well, that would certainly be a way. If your competitors are being more competitive because of the use of AI and you're not, and they're 10% more profitable than you because of that, they're gonna clean your clock.
So you think a company should hire a specific role to take over this, or depending on the size of the company, should certain departments have a person dedicated to this?
I feel like large companies certainly will have it. There'll be some sort of executive level AI role because it is so, it's a new kind of thing and very powerful and very risky. I think certain size companies will. As you go to smaller and smaller companies, I think it needs to become part of other departments. And there'll be a lot of training, I'm sure, around it as an industry start to mature. But acknowledging how important it is to understand the nature of the data, its use, and its potential inappropriate uses, and understanding it, quantifying it, and then being able to safely utilize AI. I think, you know, the worst thing you could do is put too much data into AI, and the second worst thing would be to put no data in AI.
All right, so first step in dealing with this, what do you think they should do?
In my opinion, this is just good old-fashioned blocking and tackling of application security and data security. It's have a good application security program, understand your applications, make sure they're working appropriately. Keep in mind that now we're dealing with application and data security on both ends. It's the, you know, the public side where we take data to traditional places, the website, things like that, but also the back end, the internal side. How do we keep somebody from pulling data out of the system that they shouldn't? When people talk about zero trust a lot, you know, that kind of concept of how do you take a system and contain it, not only from risk of the outside world but the inside world, and this is really a new vector. It's, you know, we started talking about zero security or zero trust with respect to some system in our data center gets attacked, and then it becomes a jump off point for an attack, and that's kind of what we thought about with zero trust. This is a new avenue of somebody not maliciously goes and grabs data out of your system and sticks it in an AI engine that they shouldn't have. Well, now I've got to defend against that inappropriate but innocent, mm-hmm. really mistake. They had a good purpose, they just did a bad thing, which is arguably more dangerous.
Let's say that they need help with this. Are you somebody that they can call for this, and how do they get in touch with you?
Yeah, they can come to our website, saltworks.io. Contact us there. There's a link there right on the homepage where they can contact us. Love to work with them. Again, it gets back to it's a new kind of problem, but it's an old-fashioned defense of having good, solid application security programs so that you can then enable it. So, it's just good, solid blocking and tackling and application security. Something we've been doing for years. Certainly is maturing, but that's something we've been doing as an industry for years, and we work with lots of people on that.
Giving us a lot to think about.
Yeah.
Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks, Scott. Right. Appreciate it.
Generative AI can be a powerful tool, but with that power comes added responsibility and risk. Any company deciding to utilize generative AI should probably first sit down with their CISO in the security roles of their company, as well as those who understand the data of your company, and talk about how it should be appropriately used and protected. A healthy balance between optimism and skepticism isn't a bad thing. If you like this kind of content, make sure to check out our website at thesecuritychampions.com. Like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and give us some feedback on what you'd like to see in future episodes. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the road.